My name's John Hartshorn. I'm a biologist and an ecologist, ex-teacher. Now I spend most of my time working outside. This morning we're in a beautiful piece of mixed woodland up in Redesdale in up in Northumberland. And this particular piece of woodland is a really good place for squirrels. Unfortunately, both greys and reds here, although we haven't seen greys in here for quite some time. So it's a great opportunity to talk to you about a little bit about squirrel ecology, about what they eat, about how we monitor them and the whole issue around squirrels. We can't show you immediately a live red squirrel here, so I have the next best thing, which is a stuffed red squirrel. Thank you very much to Northumberland Wildlife Trust for providing me with this for today. So this is a red squirrel, Sciurus vulgaris, and this is our native squirrel to the UK, or to Britain. Probably came across on land bridge from the rest of Europe about 10,000 years ago, end of the last ice age. At one time there were many hundreds of thousands of these in the country. We're now down to about 15,000 in England. More than that if you include Scotland, because Scotland and Ireland are the places where the red squirrel is now really still abundant. But in England it has been pushed out by its very close neighbour, the grey squirrel. This one is an invasive species. This one was introduced from America, from Carolina, in the late 1800s, early 1900s. It was considered to be an interesting ornamental species for large estates, etc. And it is in so many ways pushing the red squirrel out of its normal habitat. A little bit more about the red squirrel, I'll hold them together. You can see that the grey squirrel is substantially a larger species. It's more robust, it is more aggressive. And all of those things have actually meant that it has been pushing the red squirrel out. Red squirrels, in terms of what they eat, varies throughout the year. The thinnest pickings for red squirrels is actually round about this time of year in the summer, spring and summer, which is after the stores that they put down for the winter have been depleted, and after the leaves on the trees have become rather too full of tannins to be palatable for them. So they struggle a little bit at this time of year looking around for berries and things, but into the back end of the year, as we start to get more nuts formed and other fruits formed, then that's when they start to feed. So this time of year is a really good time to try and catch squirrels on camera or get them to visit feeders. Red squirrel has two litters a year if the food's good. First litter is early in the spring, second one is in the late summer. They have kits, they're called little kits, about four or five kits maybe, if again food is good. They mate in January stroke February. The grey squirrel, exactly the same sort of reproductive pattern, same time of year, both of these species live in little places up trees called drays. There's quite a lot of debate about the drays because we think reds and greys may actually occupy the same drays or visit the same drays at different times. The red squirrel has been excluded from a lot of the UK by a number of factors. Habitat disturbance and destruction has been a problem for them, but the major problem has been the incursion of the grey squirrel, particularly because they outcompete the reds in so many ways. One of the major problems with the grey squirrel is it carries a virus called squirrel pox virus, which whilst the grey squirrels are resistant to it, the red squirrels invariably die from it. So you may hear about squirrel pox. So if greys and reds coexist in a woodland and the greys are carrying squirrel pox, then the reds will die out. And we've had that happen in this wood twice in the last few years, where we've had good populations of reds that have been completely eliminated by the presence of grey squirrels. The bottom line is that to allow the red squirrel to continue to survive in this area, then the grey squirrels have to be controlled in some way. In the long term, well, we would maybe hope that there'd be another solution for this, for grey squirrels, and there are various other strategies around to try and control grey squirrel reproduction through using a contraceptive, and that's, shall we say, a work in progress. Also, we're very hopeful that the pine marten, the natural predator of the grey squirrel, and red squirrels to some extent as well, but the pine marten is making a good comeback from Scotland, and there have been reintroductions around the country of the animal itself. It was persecuted almost to extinction. It's now coming back, and it's recently been found very close to here in Northumberland, and it does seem to be having a deterrent effect on the grey squirrels in those areas. So that, again, that's the ideal, isn't it, to get those apex predators back into the system so that these invasive species can be controlled in a natural way.